Welcome, friends, to this final session we have of this three-day workshop, three-day Bhandara of Great Master Hazur Maharaj Baba Sawan Singh. And I'm very pleased that you all joined me for the celebration. The celebration was to remember somebody who taught us the real way to go back to our true home. He told us that this is a simple way and a natural way. It's not man-made. It's a gift given to all human beings. All human beings have the capacity to go back to their true home. That the true home is within themselves and can be discovered within their own bodies. And not only within their own bodies, whatever else is within them, they can discover that too. And therefore, he gave simple methods of meditation, which is go within, behind your eyes. That's where your consciousness is operating. Use methods like repetition of words, they call it mantra or simran. Repeat them so that the mind does not get a chance to repeat thoughts. Replace thoughts with those words. That will help you to stabilize behind the eyes. And by repetition, putting attention on listening to those words, not mere repetition. Remember, it's more important to listen to those words than to remember what they are. Listening is the real capacity of the soul. Speaking is the capacity of the mind. And therefore, listening is more important. Once you listen to the words you are repeating, you will begin to listen to the sound of music of your own self, which lies within you. That sound can be heard within yourself and can be heard to an extent it will pull you. There are many sounds you hear, like practice sounds, which do not pull you. But with practice of staying behind the eyes, you will be able to get to a point where you will be able to get pulled by that sound. Once that sound pulls you, you will be able to become unaware of this physical body rapidly. Otherwise, it takes longer. So once you are able to draw your attention through this process, you are able to go within and find out this is not your entire self. This body was merely a cover upon yourself. It was a cover upon yourself to create physical experience, to create a physical world around you. After that, you go into another state and find there is a sensory system, a sensory body we call the astral body. And that body creates a whole astral world for us, where sense perceptions function without a body. Sense perceptions are active, and that is a body. It's not a body really. It's not really a physical thing. It is only sense perceptions functioning by themselves, and that's called the astral body. So all sense perceptions are the same. You can then, in that sensory body, again go within that, because it has a form. It's placed in a certain position. The senses work like that. You can withdraw your attention similarly inside and listen to another set of musical sounds that come up, and those that pull you in, and you go into another state where you even become unaware of your sensory perceptions. And that opens up something which would be called the causal plane, mental plane, where the mind can function by itself without the senses and the body. Perception is directly through the mind. These are experiences which anybody can have with a simple practice. But that is not the end of our spiritual journey. In fact, the spiritual journey begins after that, where none of these methods can be used, because all these methods require effort and mental effort. And when the mind itself is there, is the limit of the mind, how can you use mental effort beyond that? So what works beyond that is what exists beyond that, and what really exists beyond that is love, intuitive knowledge, bliss, joy, appreciation of beauty. These things do not come from the mind. Even when we are here, they come from our soul, from our inmost conscious self. And you can reach that only by being pulled from the other side with these functions. What really pulls us on this path, the path that Baba Sawan Singh taught, was that love can pull you. That is why you find that these perfect living masters who come and work for us here, they draw us virtually all the time from the beginning with their unconditional love. Their love is different from other that we experience because it's unconditional. They have no judgment involved. They don't judge you if you're good or bad. They don't judge you what your karma is. They judge you by your seeking. Are you a seeker of the truth? Are you a seeker of true love? Are you a seeker of the ultimate consciousness? If you are, they'll be there to help you. You don't have to take the trouble of looking for them and finding them. They will come to you. When your seeking is ready and you are ready, they will themselves appear. By strange kinds of coincidences, by strange circumstances, they come into your own life. And then you recognize them in time only from their unconditional love. At the time when you go beyond the mind, which is necessary if you want to cross the threshold from where the karma, mind, space and time exist, you want to cross that, only the unconditional love pulls you. And that's the role of perfect living masters, to take you beyond the mind into your true realm of pure consciousness, pure spirit. And that is where you have ultimate love, bliss, joy, appreciation, beauty, things of which there is no opposite there. But this world has been created as the opposite of that, so that you can reach there and leave this world, which is the opposite of that. This, in short, is a simple thing, and I had a great time with you. I enjoyed myself these last 3 days with you, explaining the same thing. It is simple, it is natural, is given to everybody. As I mentioned, this audience itself contains people from all the continents of this earth planet. This contains people who are black and white, yellow and brown and all other colors. They are people of all genders. You saw children, small children and big children. I saw many big children. Some people call me a big child. Yesterday my friend referred to me as a baby. But this is a child in each one of us. It's good that we have a child in each one of us, because the child's love is pure. Actually, when we become children, our love becomes pure. It says, unless ye be like little children, thou shalt not see the kingdom of God. You have to be like little children. Little children's love is innocent and pure. And we become like little children, our love becomes innocent and pure. Otherwise, we get involved so much in our emotional activities here. We get into such a mess with these things that we have no time for this thing. Our attention is totally diverted. But we can pull our attention back and find the true thing. I would suggest to you now that you go home. Have a nice, pleasant journey back. I wish you a Merry Christmas yesterday. It was a white Christmas in April. The whole place was white. So I was very happy to give you greetings in every language I can give you greetings. So when you go back home, try to practice what it is. More important than practice, use a priority in your life. Make your spiritual journey, your spiritual practice, priority number one. When you wake up in the morning, say, this is my highest priority. All other things that you do in life should follow that. But if you say, I am so busy, I have so much to do, I have my work to do, take care of my family, I have to cook food, I have to do these things, and when I get time, I will do meditation. Meditation will never come. That other thing will occupy you all the time. If you make it priority number one, meditation will be the first thing. And I am saying, meditate for a few minutes, 5 minutes. Some people have criticized me, why are you reducing the time for meditation from 2.5 hours to 5 minutes? I'm not reducing any time. You can do meditation all day if you like. I am only saying that to retain this priority, meditate for 5 minutes in the morning when you wake up, and then do the rest of your job. Before going to sleep, 5 minutes more, so that the sleep itself becomes meditation. You can't imagine if you do 5 minutes of your meditation before going to sleep, the whole sleep becomes meditation. You can wake up in the middle and you are meditating. So don't think that sleep takes you away from meditation if you meditate before going to sleep. If you do these two things, your priorities are intact. And then you will be meditating all the time as a natural process that is available to us. I wish you all great good luck. Have a nice time back home. and I'll see you again. We'll be having a meditation workshop. This place, as you might see right now, is too crowded. Some people, so many had to sit on the floor and others had to stand yesterday, I saw. So that is why we are going to move to another location and wait for the announcements. Most likely, the September workshop will be another township where they found a university place which is larger, can accommodate more people in Menominee, Wisconsin. So you might like to check when the announcements are made, and I'll be very happy to see you again there. Thank you very much. God bless, and go home peacefully and safely. Thank you. I'll now continue with my interviews for initiation, which were left over from yesterday. And then after I finish that, all of them may not be done today, but those who are staying until tomorrow, I'll meet them tomorrow morning. So otherwise, you only ask for interviews, they will continue for the next 2 days. Thank you very much.